be very challenging in that sense, you know what I mean? So, and then you've got obviously a broad range of tools nowadays, softwares that can, from Microsoft Project to Primavera to Astra to financial softwares like SAP, which do the cost reporting. Microsoft Project and Primavera, they help you in estimating the duration of the projects. So there's a range of tools, and for simpler, smaller projects, we even have softwares that actually help you manage that project. If it's a simpler project. So in Australia, a lot of the private sector, small businesses, they use web-based softwares that you subscribe per month. So it could be $100 a month, it could be $200 a month, and which is a simple software, and that helps you manage your projects. But these projects are very small, right? Obviously, the large projects, you would need a full-time project manager and a fully resourced team. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. You have rightly pointed out 8 types of tools to be used in a project. You have started with the expert judgment or stakeholder consultation before drafting a project. Yes, it is very much indeed required, because what would be the benefit of this project for different stakeholder groups? And it could be consulted with the expert pool, expert series of expert consultation meeting could be there. So use obviously historical data, because how far it was affected, what was the before even 50 years or 100 years data could be used for determining the strength of a project, or what sort of tools and instruments should be used. It should be determined through analysis of different models. You have rightly pointed out that different models are available for analyzing a new project. And you have advice to ensure use of technology like softwares or web subscription. These sort of technologies are available. So if we use this sort of technology in project management, then obviously it will be successfully implemented. You have also that project manager. It is a very, very important thing. Under a skilled professional project manager, any project could be implemented easily with a well-balanced, equipped team. Obviously, finally, you have mentioned that a project team is also a very important tool of a project. Thank you very much, sir. Now, I would like to know what are the different documents required for project management? In a project, what are the documents very vital for project implementation and project management?
So it will vary. So the project mainly has according to the project management body of knowledge, the project mainly has like 5 phases. So initiation, planning, then you've got execution, then you've got monitoring and control, and then you close the project. So there's that 5 phases broadly. And during the initiation, which is very important, this is in the initiation phase, you have what's called a project charter. Why you're doing the project? Who are the stakeholders? Who's going to benefit? What are some of the major risks? Then once the charter is agreed, you have a business case, which is, we call it a business plan in Australia. But in Bangladesh, we call it feasibility study. Yeah. So we do a feasibility study of the project. And when we do a feasibility study for a development project or a government project, it's not just about the economic direct benefits. It's about the indirect benefits, like your job growth, connectivity, loss of lives, the reduction in loss of accidents, which leads to loss of lives, better quality of life. And as you said, the impact on unemployment reduction, there could be an indirect benefit there. So once that is done properly, then we move on to what's called a project management plan, which is encompassing everything basically. So the project management plan will have everything in terms of, it'll have a time management plan, it'll have a risk management plan, you'll have a procurement management plan, you'll have a communication management plan, a stakeholder engagement plan, you know, and then you get the funding for your project, and then you can execute your project. So from a project manager's angle, like I've been working for a government side project manager here in Australia, you know, with the state government and the local government is also. And because we're in the government, we are the leaders. So we do this front end, we call it the front end, which is the initiation and the planning phase well. We do it very well, and then we put that execution on a contract model. So we, whether it's construction of the bridge or a road or a dam or a building, we have a procurement strategy, then we implement that strategy, and we hire a construction contractor, a specialist contractor. and you'll see, because our planning is very well done, we encounter less issues in construction. But what I see in Nepal is the planning is very weak. Like the government offices there are very weak in planning. And this is not trying to sort of put anyone down, but just the, also culturally, there's, we don't have in the, I don't know how it is like in the Bangladeshi culture, but in the Nepalese culture, our, we don't show that zeal at work when it comes to planning. But when it comes to wedding, when it comes to festivals, our planning zeal is very high. You know what I mean? People spend hours and nights planning for flowers, planning for the right decoration. But when it comes to the work, our zeal, you know, the amount of effort we put in planning is very minimal. So it culturally also is there. But then we also lack the project management skills to properly plan, to properly scope the job, to define the boundaries of what we're trying to do. And then we, it lands us into trouble. And when you go to construction, we can't spend the yearly budget on time. There's, then we blame the contractor. Like the contractor is the weakest entity in the developing country, as you know. So then we blame the contractor for, we say this contractor hasn't done his job properly. See what I'm saying? And the public buys that story from the government. But in a country like Australia, the public will not buy that story from the government. If the government says, oh, this project was delayed because of contractor Mr. So-and-so, public will say, sorry, you are the government. You are the expert. You did the planning. You did all the initiation. You did all the studies. You selected these contractors. What, how did you select it? What criteria did you use? So maybe you're not competent to select the right person anyway. So the public will put it back on the government because it's a leadership issue, it's an accountability issue. And the reason I'm saying this is Nepal lacks, obviously we have issues with corruption, which I don't think there's, as a project management professional, we're not talking about that today. And it could be beyond our scope to address it, but I could address the issue of project management. So you can, there are two things vital in terms of why the projects are not delivered properly. One is the corruption, and the second is the lack of project management skills. The corruption, I may not be do much about it or talk much about it, but if we improve the project management, definitely we can deliver more for the public of Nepal, for the government of Nepal, where the unemployment rate is so high, right? And I think Bangladesh, similar, like I'm not saying it's as worse as Nepal, but similar where they can meet their target of spending of 90%. I think there was a, they have a massive capital works budget also. So if the project management capability is strengthened, your spending capacity would be more than 95%, which means reduction in unemployment, right? So more people will get employed, more industries engaged, less people going overseas for jobs out of Bangladesh. So you can see there's a huge impact. Like this is just a huge impact in that sense, yeah.
So thank you very much. you have rightly pointed out that a project has at least five phases. Number one was initiation. You have rightly pointed out in the initiation stage, we will finalize the project charter. and the mission, vision, and goal of the project.